الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله، since we're at the end of Ramadan, and may Allah تبارك وتعالى accept our worship of Him and Him alone, and bless us to have the ثمرات of Ramadan, the fruits of Ramadan in our actions. May Allah bless us with better manners. May Allah تبارك وتعالى bless us to continue fasting on Mondays and Thursdays. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with righteous deeds and to be conscious of what we speak about and what we look at and what we listen to. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless us to continue striving for the halal and striving to come closer to Him. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq in spending in His cause and bless us with the wealth so that we can spend in His cause. Tabarak wa ta'ala, ya razaq, razaqana. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with everything good and forgive us and protect us and forgive us from everything evil. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Muslims everywhere, protect the Muslims everywhere, forgive the Muslims everywhere, guide the Muslims everywhere back to the Sunnah of His Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah guide the Ashiris to the Sunnah of the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah guide the Maturidiyah to the Sunnah of the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the Sufis to the correct understanding and practice of the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah bless us to be Salafi in our deeds and in our actions, in our understanding of Islam and the practice in accordance with the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'een, and according to the maqsid, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, and in accordance with what the Prophet alayhi afdal salatu wasalam propagated. May Allah protect us from kufr, shirk, and nifaq. May Allah guide the takfiris from their evil and wicked and sinful devilish ways in distorting the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I just wanted to mention something, and I hope that Allah accepts that dua, and I hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives us, and I hope Allah tabarak wa ta'ala blesses us to have Qiyam al-Layl, and for Him tabarak wa ta'ala to accept it, and to clean our wicked sins. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our hearts to the worship of Him and Him alone, because that's what it's all about. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Listen to this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is the importance of Ramadan, the importance of having Iman, faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the importance of seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's reward and hoping to attain His pleasure and hoping to attain His reward. An Abi Hurairah, أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال من قام رمضان إيمان واحتساب غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه رواه بخاري. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith of Abi Hurairah رضي الله تعالى عنه that whoever stands in Ramadan, meaning stands قيام الليل, stands قام رمضان إيمانا, with إيمان, believing in Allah, believing in His reward, and expecting and hoping for His favors and His forgiveness and hoping for His reward and that He will accept your deeds, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ, then all of His deeds, all of his sins that he did will be forgiven. And the ulama mentioned, except for the kaba'ir, the major sins, that means you have to make tawbah for those sins. So if you are committing zina, and I want to make a point, ahabatifillah, that something that's very important, it's a reminder first and foremost to myself, then my brothers and sisters, is that, as one of the imams here mentioned, that unfortunately there's a lot of shabab, mashallah, they're fasting. I live close to Bahrain, and I'm not trying to expose the sins of the Muslims, but I just want to give you a picture that many of the youth, they go there and they get their party on. Okay. Everything they do right now, it's become holy for a lot of the youth, and some of them, they are expecting, they are actually expecting and waiting to take the vacation of Maasi right after Ramadan, to go to travel to do sin, to make up for what they missed. And this is what the imam was saying, and I know it from personal mixing with the people and understanding some of the youth and some of the issues they go with. This is something we have to strive our best to gain the benefit of Ramadan and seek the forgiveness and seek to come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remove the sin. Oh Allah, please help us to be better slaves of yours. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. In another hadith, وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ سَمَى رَمَضَانِ إِيمَانُ وَاحْتِسَابٍ غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ رواه بخاري. This is the hadith in Bukhari. It's the same hadith that we mentioned, whoever stands in Ramadan seeking with Iman, seeking to gain the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive him what he did from his sins. And again, we mentioned, except for the kaba'ir, the major sins, you have to make toba from the major sins. وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ مَنْ يُقُمْ لَيْلَةُ الْقَدْرِ إِيمَانًا وَاحْتِسَابًا غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذِنْبِهِ رُوَاهُ بُخَارِي. This is also a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that in Bukhari, that whoever stands in Laylatul Qadr, believing in Allah, believing that this night, and what the Quran mentions about it, and what the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentions about it, and they are in hope and expecting and seeking the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive them of their sins. So may Allah forgive us our sins. May Allah bless us to be of those who are standing in Laylatul Qadr and not wasting our time. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with ilm al-nafiyah, wa rizqan tayyibah, wa amalan mutaqabbilan, wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.